after the dramas at the iPro earlier, where Hull City beat Derby County 3-0, we have more excitement from the playoffs, from League One and League Two. Barnsley have already been smitten by the Wembley Trail this season, having won the Johnson's Paint Trophy. They've reached the final in both their previous playoff campaigns, and they demolished champions Wigan at the weekend. They face Walsall, who are desperate to return to the Championship after a 12-year absence. They were just pipped to an automatic spot by Burton, despite pushing them all the way with an emphatic win on Sunday. Next, it's Wimbledon, who caused one of the greatest shocks at Wembley. But the latest reincarnation of the Dons have never made it to a Wembley final and are looking to be promoted to League One for the first time in their short history. Their opponents have also reincarnated over the years, and like Wimbledon, this current Accrington Stanley team have never made it to a Wembley final. They ran out of luck when automatic promotion was on the cards last weekend, and this would be a telling test to see if they can overcome that disappointment. So a little later this evening from the Cherry Red Record Stadium, it's the League Two playoff semi-final first leg. AFC Wimbledon against Accrington Stanley, and kickoff is at 7:30. But our first game takes us to Yorkshire for the League One playoff semi-final first leg, as Barnsley take on Walsall from Oakwell. So four teams coming up this evening, each with their own great story to tell of how the season has gone and how they want it to go even better. I'm talking of better, we couldn't have two better guests. Ian Holloway had five playoff campaigns as a manager, reaching the final four times and being promoted twice, both of those to the Premier League. He actually played under Dave Bassett, who had seven career promotions as a manager, but no success in three playoff campaigns, losing finals in 1996 with Crystal Palace and 2000 with Barnsley. Gentlemen, great to see you. Dave, sorry to bring that up. Bad memories, I'm sure, but just how difficult are the playoffs?
They're very, very difficult. I mean, these are the important ones. The Wembley's a one-off. I mean, obviously, it's the worst place to lose in a playoff final. But the important factor is getting the results in those first games. And both teams I were with, we won the away leg, which was vital because it puts pressure on the other team when they've got to, they're at home. They have then got to commit themselves. They can't be patient and that, and you've got the chances then to do it, although they were both very hard games and the return leg. So it is tension, there's no doubt about it, because it comes there and you look at your season. I mean, when I was at Crystal Palace, we were third, we were 17 points in front of Leicester, and they did us in the final with the last kick of the game, and you think, well, life's not too fair in that respect.
It's certainly not. What's key for you in terms of going up this way, Ian?
I think it's doing well in that first game. I managed to do well in that. We were at home, and we managed to also go away and do well as well. So it's all about staying calm, really, and realising that you just got to try and keep your mind on the process. And if you can do that and bring your best game, like Sheffield Wednesday did last night,
yeah,
to be
definitely.
Fair to them. So, you know, as far as I'm concerned, it's a bit of luck then. You know, you need your fans to be with you and things to go your way, and but the lads did us proud because they stayed on task.
What about Wimbledon, Dave, as well, for the ninth tier of English football to the fourth, possibly the third? How big a story is it and how similar do you see it as well?
Well, it's a tremendous story because they started off at the bottom and came through all the leagues, and what they'd done was absolutely brilliant. I mean, Wimbledon, I played and we got into the league. The club existed at that particular time. I think it was a different era for them, but they've done remarkably well, and this is, you know, tremendous with the option of that possibly we're going to a new stadium, etc. The club has got into the playoffs this year.
And possibly playing MK Dons next season.
Yeah,
how ironic is that?
There's all this bit about MK Dons and Wimbledon, and there is a certain amount of animosity, but really that isn't the factor. You know, that might be a side event. The important thing is to get up and then worry about who you play. And again, if you're playing MK Dons in the League One, it's only two games. It's what you do over the end of the season. It's no good losing them two win them two games and get relegated.
Yeah. What about Neil Ardley as well here? Brought in 3 years ago to try and keep them into the Football League. He did it on the very last day. Roll on 3 years. He's on the verge of promotion.
Well, he's been fantastic. I mean, I personally know Neil. He's a great lad, and he's got such a young team, you know, and he works well with young people, and and he deserves to be given time, and that's what he's done. He loves the club, doesn't he, H? He's a great fella.
He was here as a schoolboy when I was manager. I mean, Neil then developed and came through the team and contributed, playing a lot of games, and he went away. And he's an intelligent boy. I mean, at the time when he was appointed here, you know, he came through, he wanted to be a manager, and he was Wimbledon. And again, the good thing with this club is that they want a manager. They're not looking for somebody to do miracles, and that as such, they will stand by the manager, and they were going to stand by Neil. And he, you know, they've both been very good for one another, and the club has gradually made a little bit more progress each year.
He was a roommate of mine in the England under-21s as well. I know he's a really, really nice guy, but if he's done a great job, what about John Coleman at Accrington? I mean, the lowest budget in all four divisions, it's incredible, isn't it?
It's absolutely fantastic. You know, John's been around the block, hasn't he? He's a wonderful fella, and you know, to miss out like that they did on goal difference, having been second, it must have been a crushing blow. But the man actually, first thing he did was text Darrell Clark, Bristol Rovers manager, and congratulated him. Now, to me, that's class. And, you know, he'll have his team trying back up and running again today, well, without a shadow of a doubt.
How much will he have nightmares of what happened here earlier in the season? I mean, it was 0-0. They did score a goal, but it wasn't given. The ref blew for half-time just as the goal went in. And you could look at it as if those two extra points would have given them automatic promotion.
Yeah, you look at that now. Hey, John, don't muck about. I tell you, he won't have been happy with that.
Yeah, it's all ifs and buts and everything else. But I think what Accrington have got, because sometimes if you're the third team and you just miss out, there can be disappointment. I think Accrington come with no expectations at the start of the season, probably the lowest budget, etc., that they can play football and there's no expectations of them. And what they do is a great achievement, because they're everybody's favourite to be relegated. And John's an experienced guy. He's been around and he's got his team believing in them. And basically, he more or less has come to Accrington. If you want to play well and do well, you're likely to move on. Like Windass is now moving to Glasgow Rangers. So he's done a tremendously very good job, John. You know, probably could be manager of the year if it wasn't for Ranieri.
Wimbledon Accrington is a little later here at 7:30. First up for Mokwell, it is Barnsley against Walsall. Let's remind ourselves at the top of League One and just how it finished. Wigan were champions, Burton were promoted along with them. Walsall missed out on automatic promotion by just a single point, what with Nigel Clough's men getting a draw at Doncaster. Barnsley made it into the playoffs on goal difference above an in-form Scunthorpe after going to Wigan and getting what was an absolutely fantastic victory. And this is the team that Paul Heckenbottom puts out today. Unsurprisingly, it's unchanged from that excellent 4-1 win at the home of the champions. A 4-4-2, Hourihan and Brownhill in the middle of the park, Hamill and Isgrove out wide, with top scorer Sam Winnell, 22 goals this season, 21 in the league, up front with England under-20 international Ashley Fletcher. Well, let's hear from the Barnsley captain, Conor Hourihan, speaking to David Craig.
Just how pleased are you with the form that you're in at this minute in time?
Yeah, we've got great form. Since the turn of the year, we've been on a really good run. Had a good result last week against the champions at Wigan's home ground. So, you know, we take confidence from the run and that result as well.
Home in the first leg, do you have to really make that count?
Yeah, I think so. You know, it's going to be a great crowd out here tonight. You know, they're going to be right behind us, and hopefully we get the result that will take us into the second leg with a good result.
OK, well, this is the Walsall team. Boss John Whitney also keeps an unchanged side from last week. They beat Port Vale 5-0 at Vale Park. A 4-1-4-1 formation with Chambers holding, Laukovic, Morris, Ford and Romain Sawyer's their main man. Most things go through him, just behind Tom Bradshaw. He's got 20 goals this season in all competitions. OK, well, let's hear from the Walsall captain, Adam Chambers, again with David Craig.
Two teams in red-hot form at the minute. What's going to make the difference today?
Again, that composure, you know. I think, obviously, both teams like to play football, you know, and we'll be looking to dominate the ball if we can, and obviously they'll be looking to do the same, you know. So, obviously, if we can get an early goal, it'll be a big thing as well. So, we've just got to be calm today and really be composed on the ball.
It's two-legged. What's the mental approach from the away team?
Again, the last few games, you know, we've been playing the same way. We go out looking to win games, you know. I can't see us changing from that. We're looking to go and attack and, like I said before, try and dominate the ball.
Well, that's certainly they try to do. Both teams will try to do that. Let's join our co-commentator at Oakwell, David Prutton. David, just tell us about the atmosphere, how it's building up there.
He's building it really well, Scott, to be fair. Cracked in, as we saw last night. South Yorkshire was in full voice, so hopefully the same at Oakwell today. The Walsall fans have turned up in good number and it's set up to be a really good game.
What's key for you, for either of these sides, in terms of getting to Wembley?
I think it's a case, so we've just heard from both the managers and players involved there, it's about playing the right type of game, their type of game, both very expansive, both allowed to get forward with the kind of defensive options that they've got, and playing the kind of the game, not necessarily the occasion. John Wynn is very much, he was out here before, actually putting the cones out and still micromanaging every little bit of his team. So he'll want his team to relax and play as well as they can do, and Paul Heckingbottom, they've got the weight of Barnsley behind, they've got this wonderful crowd in full voice, they've got to use that energy, channel that energy into the game.
Both in form coming into this game, of course. How do you see it going over the two legs?
Well, I think what we've seen so far in the playoffs, no team's really held back, have they? Everyone's gone for it. There's been no caginess within the first legs. I hope to see more of the same. Something high scoring would be great, obviously, for us to talk about and for you to digest. But, as I said, two teams with the shackles off really going for it.
They will indeed, David. Enjoy the game. Thanks very much.
Pleasure.
Ian, this really is a tough call, isn't it? Especially with that fantastic win that Barnsley got last week against Wigan. How surprised were you with the result and also the scoreline as well?
I was gobsmacked. I actually believed that going to Wigan had already got promotion. They were going to be champions and, you know, they went 1-0 down as well. So, you know, on top of that, that's an amazing comeback. And it wasn't as exactly if Wigan just sat down. I thought they played so well, Barnsley. You know, so as far as I was concerned, that shocked me more than anything, last week's results.
Well, it was an amazing result, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's a very good result. I mean, but you look at Barnes' record since Christmas and since Heckingbottom took over, you know, they've got 50 points. That's an incredible form. They'd be, you know, top of the league. If they had started the season off, they'd have been the champions. So they've got confidence and they've built up and they've gradually grown strength. And I think what's happened with Heckingbottom being a local lad, it's given Barnsley fans something to hang on to, because I think they were becoming disillusioned. They'd had a lot of managers, things weren't going right, and all of a sudden they think he's one of their own. So I think there's a hell of a momentum in Barnsley, and you know, it's going to be a hard game for Walsall today. But again, Walsall, you know, have got the best away record in that league, so it's going to be intriguing to call these games. Is very, very difficult because things can change. The other night, Portsmouth, you know, go a goal up, but when the centre-half decides to tread on the ball and be France Beckenbauer and look like Mickey Mouse to give the ball away, you don't need something like that.
You talk about momentum. Barnsley certainly have it. If you look back to December, they were bottom of League One after a run of 8 consecutive losses. Picked up, and since the turn of the year, they've been the most informed side in League One. In fact, no team in England's top four divisions have won more games this calendar year in all competitions than Barnsley. It's some turnaround, Ian, isn't it?
That's amazing. Paul deserves all sorts of credit. And I think Harry's right. You know, Harry knows the club better than I do. But, you know, up there, if you're one of them, they
very
feel
important.
One of you up that in that area. They'll really buy into it. And the players have, you know, I don't know what they were doing before, and it's the same ones, isn't it? I think they added Adam Hamill. They got him back, and that's a big take for him. He's a fantastic winger who opens things up, and you know, as I say, with Sam Winnall as well, fantastic.
But how much credit goes to the board? One, for sticking with Lee Johnson at that time, and then two, with seeing Paul Heckingbottom take over. He's still only caretaker manager.
That's right. I mean, well, Lee Johnson at one stage, everybody thought he was just about to go every week. You're thinking it's done, which was sort of a bit unlike Barnsley, but they stuck with it. And then it turned out for Lee a good move to Bristol City. And they've obviously said to Heckingbottom, you know, step into the role as caretaker. Let's see how you do. And again, sometimes you can appoint a caretaker manager too quickly. But I would think at the end of the season, when they look at what he's done and how he's bonded the club and the players together, you know, I'd be very surprised if he doesn't get a job. If not, he'll soon get a job elsewhere.
I'm sure he will. Let's hear from both managers, John Whitney and Paul Heckingbottom, with David Craig.
It's a two-legged affair. Does that change the mental approach?
Well, we've had one this season anyway in the JPT, which is helpful for us. We're just approaching it as a 180-minute game. So whatever the outcome today, it's half-time. We have to make sure we're still in the match at half-time, and that's it.
We always go to win. I think we only play one way. That's why our away form is one of the best in the league. We're a solid team, but we're very dangerous on the break, and we've got some real attacking technical players. So, like we always play every game, we'll go to win, but we also won't be too cavalier. We leave ourselves quite open at the back.
It's been the biggest game of our season. I mean, we had a great atmosphere earlier on when we played Everton in the League Cup, and We're expecting even more fans here today, bigger atmosphere, a bigger prize. So, yeah, when it's the emotion and tension of something that's, you know, you've got something massive at stake, then you expect there to be more noise, more atmosphere, because there's more enjoyment.
I'm expecting a real tough game. Two footballing teams. I think for the neutral, this is a great game for people tonight, and hopefully we can showcase where and what League One has to offer. It's a great opportunity for my players to raise their profile yet again, and for Walsall Football Club to keep up with its reputation that we've built over the last 4 or 5 years.
The beaters here in the league, we went to them and beat them, so we respect each other. We know about each other's, you know, strengths and weaknesses, and I think we're a similar type of teams. You know, we both like to play football. And I think you can expect a good open game.
I'd like to get pull the reins back in on them this weekend, calm them down a bit more, because we've got a great momentum going and we're going to carry that forward into tonight.
Extremely positive, John Whitney. That's the way he is. Amazing story, isn't it, how the season has unfolded for him. Started it as the sports scientist and physio, ends it as the head coach. Do you know any physios in your time that could have done that?
Well, there's a few. The few told me they could. They thought they were better than I was, and they were probably right. But I think what's happened is Dean Smith was doing a terrific job there. He went to Brentford, and what's happened is John's taken over, and he's continued it. He hasn't changed it. He's continued in that way. And continuity is very good. I mean, we've seen that at Burton with Gary Rowett, did a terrific job. Jimmy came in and continued it, and Nigel Clough. And, you know, it says some credit to the board and the people not to come in and tinker too much.
Yeah, Sean O'Driscoll didn't quite work out there. But in terms of what he's doing, he has taken on the good work from Dean Smith. He wants his players to develop themselves and read the game themselves. Do you think that's the good way of promoting a style of football?
I think that's the only way you can do it. You've got to get the lads to understand why they need to be here, why they need to do this, and connect it all. It's the modern way. And, you know, sports science is adding a lot to training-wise. And obviously, you know, people talk about the transitions of games. Not many coaches when I was playing actually talked about that. You're in the wrong position. But now it's not just that. Where, you know, in that transition, were you quick enough? Did you do your job well? So, you know, it's all going that way. But it's nice for me to actually see today's game. I think I've watched some brilliant football this year. I've been lucky to go on at 10-10, and Walsall was one of the venues I went to. And do you know, I can't wait to see this game today. There's some brilliant young footballers on this pitch, and, you know, like so after. So, you know, hopefully it'll be good and they'll be able to produce what they've been producing all season.
I talked of a problem solving. I should just give the ball to Gianfranco Zola and Paolo Cagna. That was my way of solving problems. But in terms of coming into this game as well, I mean, that 5-0 win at Vale Park, I mean, how important was that? That they obviously missed out on automatic promotion, but they put in a performance and a scoreline like that.
Well, they needed to win to put the pressure on for that third spot, didn't they? It looked a bit forlorn, but they've gone there, and Port Vale's not the easiest place. It's all right to say perhaps they had their deck chairs out, but to go and score 5 goals at Port Vale is not easy, and that's a bit embarrassing for them.
Oh, they were brilliant on the day. You know, when this is what you want as a manager. When the pressure's on, can they forget that and just do their job? You know, and that's what I was saying last night. I watched Sheffield Wednesday do that. I'm sure these two teams, particularly Walsall, will want to put on a show and show us what they're all very, very good at.
Some great goals there. Romain Soyuz is the big talent. How important will he be today?
Fantastic player. He's a brilliant player. You know, if you can get him on the ball, he's had a great upbringing. He was at West Brom as a kid. And, you know, I was waxing lyrical about his passing. Harry, his passing is unbelievable. You know, he moves like a Premier League player. And, you know, hopefully he'll get there one day, and, you know, maybe he'll do it with Walsall.
Well, he's probably refound himself. He probably didn't do what he should have done at West Brom because he was probably young, and the opportunity's come, and it's been a great move for him to go to Walsall and sort of be re-educated and then developed as a player. He's now sort of 23, isn't he, around about that age, where he's learned, and now he knows what is what's required, and there's every chance, if he can continue, that he can move up the league. If it's not with Walsall, probably another club.
It is all quiet here at the Cherry Red Records Stadium. Busy a little bit later on. It is busy at the moment at Oakwell. Anticipation of what is to come. It is Barnsley against Walsall in the League One playoff semi-final first leg. And kickoff is just in a few minutes' time. The Football League playoff semi-final first legs continue now. It's League One. Barnsley, who finished the season in sixth against Walsall, who missed out on automatic promotion on the very last day, And later at 7.30, it's AFC Wimbledon against Accrington Stanley from League Two. Things are hotting up at Oakwell. Dave Bassett and Ian Holloway alongside me here at Wimbledon. In terms of the strikers, how key is it for them to try and get themselves in the right positions for the goals? Both have got 20-plus goals this season so far, Ian.
Well, I'm really looking forward to seeing those two play today. Can they turn up? Can they bring their A game? And, you know, can they do it in such an atmosphere like this? So, you know, Tom Bradshaw, he's been to a few clubs and now he's obviously in a place that really suits him. And Sam Winnall, it just can't stop scoring.
No,
you know,
that's
brilliant,
right.
Isn't it?
What's going to be important is also the defensive side of it, that they don't make any mistakes, because they're going to be tested. And for me, the side that can defend best for the 90 minutes will succeed.
How nervy is it, these moments now?
Well, it is for the fans and everybody else. As a player, you're looking forward to it. You're excited.
What about as a manager?
Oh, well, you're sitting there and you're just thinking, holy Moses. Don't do anything stupid.
That's a polite way of saying it. That's because we're live on the telly.
Can you remember your last messages to the team in this situation?
Well, in the first legs, it was go out, just let's make sure we don't do anything silly, don't get sent off, don't get booked, don't end up giving penalties away unless so. Just be nice and calm, but at the same time, controlled aggression.
Ian?
Just remember the process, what we've been doing up to this point. We've been practicing it. Just stay calm, keep your mind in the game.
OK, the players are pretty much ready. Let's get to our commentary team at Oakwell, David Prutton and Daniel Mann.
Thank you very much, Scott. Real pleasure to be here on a glorious Yorkshire day. And for both, it's fair to say it's been a pretty eventful season. Barnsley were girding their loins through a grim relegation struggle at one point, but since December, they produced title-winning form to claim a place in the playoffs, weather the loss of manager Lee Johnson, and they've also enjoyed Wembley's success in the Johnston's Paint Trophy. Walsall looked a good bet to go up as champions under the departed Dean Smith's guidance early in the season, but after a faltering February under Sean O'Driscoll, they've sprung back under interim manager John Whitney. Both ended the regular season in style. Walsall cutting loose at Port Vale as they pursued automatic promotion. Barnsley turned it on at the home of the champions, Wigan Athletic. It is a wonderful occasion. The two teams plotting a return to the second tier. Barnsley have been to Wembley already this season. The motivation of Wembley failure last season for Walsall in the Johnston's Paint Trophy final is one factor for them. Desperate for a chance to put it right on the big stage this season and earn, it has to be said, a much bigger prize. Teams have momentum. Both name unchanged sides for the fourth successive game. Barnsley have been grateful for the goals of Sam Winall, 22 this season, and his head was not turned by the attentions of Leeds in January. Conor Horahan has proved an outstanding performer in midfield, 11 goals, 10 of them with that lethal weapon of a left foot. Adam Hamill struck a wondrous winner in the Johnston's Paint Trophy final at Wembley last month. The former Liverpool white man could be the one to sprinkle some stardust. Well, one of Walsall's stars has been Romain Sawyers, a member of the Divisional Team of the Year and a runner-up in the individual category. From that midfield role, he'll keep in touch with the prolific Tom Bradshaw, who hoped to couple promotion with a place at the European Championship with Wales. The glue holding it all together is veteran skipper Adam Chambers, who dominated the club's Player of the Year awards and has just signed a new one-year deal. Barnsley's is a talented young bench, including 18-year-old Harry Chapman, whose parent club Middlesbrough have already celebrated promotion Jordi Hueler, the former Manchester City striker, could be one to watch for Walsall. Well, it is the battle of the caretaker managers. John Whitney of Walsall and Paul Heckingbottom, a man with Barnsley in his blood. It is the first of two bouts for a place at Wembley, and it is live next. Well, we've talked about the men who can do the damage in an attacking sense. Here's a man who keeps things pretty solid at the back for Barnsley, David.
Absolutely, we've lauded, as you quite rightly said, on the attacking attempt. You've got to acknowledge the defensive push that's helped Barnsley push himself so far at the league. Adam Mawson, a classy centre-half, a very, very consistent player for Barnsley and very, very well regarded. Players' player of the year. One of the kind of tick-box ultimate teammates that you'd probably want to play with. Adam Chambers sat in front of the back four, using all of his experience, all of his years in the game to help guide this very, very energetic, forward-thinking Walsall team up the league.
Home advantage has proved to be anything but in this fixture. Each winning on the other's ground in the regular season, there are not that many clear pointers. One thing we do know is that both will go into this game with a positive and attractive approach. And it is Walsall in their change strip who get the game underway. No real hangover. They did miss out on automatic promotion only on the final day, but didn't they put on a show at the Wembley of the North, Vale Park. Some wonderful football. Five goals.
They definitely gave it a go, but you say, Dan, there's different ways of looking at getting into the playoffs if you miss out on automatic promotion, but if you can get into it after such a good performance, a prolific performance, it's going to give you the momentum.
Obviously, we're involved in a right old tussle to steal that sixth place on the last day of the season. And tremendous performance at the newly crowned champions, some way to do it. They're looking to make tracks early on here, and Ashley Fletcher was loitering with intent, the man they borrowed from Manchester United. Josh Scoen, essentially a midfielder filling in at right back, taking the throw. Here's Scoen again. Oh, Winnall's in there looking for something. Who's it going to drop? Dimitri, who got there crucially first. Oh, also rather unsettled here. Got to find a way out, and they have done so and found Anthony Ford. But the nerves were certainly jangling, the alarm bells were certainly ringing.
Really showing their intention very early on in this game, Barnsley. They just don't deal with it at all well. Too many balls bouncing here. Bounces first and foremost. Nobody swings a leg at it. This next one, though, they're looking for the goalkeeper to come out, but it's not the goalkeeper's ball to deal with, it's the defence's ball.
Coming underneath it, had to cope with the attentions there of Ashley Fletcher, the tall, rangy front man. The progress made by Lalkovic. Chelsea man, former Barnsley man indeed. Aaron Morris finding Dimitriou. Soyuz. Who has in his time at Walsall divided opinion a bit. He's a player often, he's often been more respected by his peers than by the supporters. And his performances have certainly helped them form to him this year.
We'll see more of Romain Soyuz just trying to play off Tom Bradshaw, help to link the midfield in this 4-1-4-1 formation. We have got the added security of Adam Chambers just sat in front of the back four, as you said, just before kick-off, which allows them to get forward. Because sometimes 4-1-4-1 can seem to be a bit defensive, but when you've got the numbers to get forward and the base to work from, it can really open up the game.
Ball down. It's George Williams. Closing down vigorously. Yeah. on each other's grounds earlier in the season. They've also got identical records historically as well. 16 wins apiece. Well, he's not yet been given the job, Paul Heckingbottom, despite doing a wonderful job in what still must be described as a temporary stint, that they just wanted to interfere with things at a delicate time, with so much at stake.
Speaking to Paul Heckingbottom in the week, I think he's been in the fortunate position where he's taken over a squad that obviously he knows really, really well for working with him a lot, but they've always had something to chase this season. They've always needed to win the next game, whether it's to be get through the JPT or get them into a decent enough position within the league. So that it's never needed to kind of sit and have that conversation. I'm very sure it's for something after wherever the playoffs leave them, but it's been a very, very good job so far, auditioning for it.
They're into him, but he's still an interim. That's Winnall. Here's Lloyd Isgrove. A little tussle there with Chambers. The Welsh international has won, and it's a threatening ball indeed.
It's a really, really ball in from Lloyd Isgrove. He just changes the angle when he checks back onto his left foot, allows the runs to be made. I think the question's asked of Adam Hamill, can he make this one at the back post? Can he get there? Dimitriou.
Lloyd Isgrove, another loanee from Southampton. Getting to grips with Dimitriou, that's what the fullback was complaining about. The Cypriot international. Warson. John Whitney, a man whose personal positivity is certainly reflected in his team's play. Been getting better and better all the time as results become more and more important to them. They've had many a high-stakes game in recent weeks.
I think what's benefited John Whitney has been there at the real kind of birth of what Dean Smith and the owners at Walsall really wanted to happen with this club, to build something that might last, to get a kind of way of playing and a philosophy of playing, not just with the first team, but all the way down through the youth squad. It's a testament to his abilities to be able to learn, to adapt, to educate himself, that he's taken to this interim coach, head coach, shall we say, like a duck to water.
Well, some might argue every manager's an interim manager these days.
You are a cynic.
Ah, yes. Guilty as charged, I'm afraid. It's Conor Horan. Lloyd Isgrove. Scoe. Play as a wing back occasionally earlier in the season. Before the start of the campaign, meant he was one of the first names on the team sheet, but he's had to take the fleeting opportunity he's been given in the latter period of the campaign.
Of what Walsall have come in, what they want to try and do. Well, any kind of attacking intent that Barnsley have got, control of possession of the game, safety in the numbers that got within the middle of the park.
Fletcher, Chambers, here Morris, forward, Morris, and we've been into this more central position in the last few games has been very effective indeed. Here's Fletcher trying to get away. Very happy that there was nothing wrong with the challenge by Downing.
It's a misconstrued flick on that got Ashley Fletcher almost away.
Morris, real purpose about this. Important intervention there by Josh Brownhill. Very impressively in midfield for Barnsley since he arrived from Preston. That's Roberts. Brownhill. Dimitriou. Bradshaw's the target. A lot of injury problems last season, but was still mightily prolific. They've actually done John Whitney in his then physio role. Doing some very important work to get more game time out of him this year because of his hamstring issues, including some special insoles for his boots.
John Whitney did say that it's a real benefit because it's something that he knows how to do now that he's in charge, manage the players. Look at the warning signs for the players. If a player's being overworked or overrun, then when to drop them in, when to drop them out, and obviously the physical side of it. It's the case where the manager can go barging in and blame the physio for not having a full team when it's both of them, to be honest.
Williams. Alfie Mawson's underneath that, helped on by Conor Horahan. James O'Connor. This divisional playoff with Doncaster Rovers back in 2008. I'm happy to remind you of that, David. Bit of your playoff pass coming up.
I'll give you that one, Dan.
Don't worry. Don't worry, we won't mention the red card against Yeovil. Oh, sorry.
Colin Calderwood did that last night.
Here's Hammer.
But he's been a big feature of Walsall this season, James O'Connor. Obviously, traditionally, he's played a lot of his games at fullback throughout his career, but really settled into that centre-half position to, again, another guy, an experienced hand within a team that's full of youth and energy.
Forward. Here's Rico Henry, who's a real star in the making. Sawyers. Warren tussling. But Sawyers may pick up a little bit of space. Roberts hurling himself in there. Capture from non-league in the summer. That's tenacious play by Hamill. Well, the competitive instincts are sharp, as you would come to expect. It's been a tremendous start to this playoff campaign on the South Coast on Thursday and here in South Yorkshire last night. Is Chambers. Fletcher on Chambers. Peter Banks, the referee. Just a few words for you in that situation.
Yeah. I admire the commitment of Ashley Fletcher to get back and work on the deepest midfield man, but just missed time on his challenge.
Henry. It's on by Morris. There was Roberts. James O'Connor. Walsall's way. Hey. it's Morris. Bradshaw entering with intent. Davis comes to deal with it. If you're interested in the history, there's one intriguing quirk. As far as Barnsley are concerned, they have a 100% away record. In playoff semi-finals, a 0% home record. Lost the first leg here against Huddersfield back in 2006 when they were promoted from this level, which Paul Heckingbottom will know all about because he went on and scored a penalty in the shootout final against Swansea. Not sure, a little unsure of his bearings, but he'll pick up the pieces now. Isgrove to unleash one! That's a very important touch from Neil Etheridge.
Fairly quiet 15 minutes, but this has really sparked into life now with this effort from Lloyd Isgrove. They don't really clear the lines too well, Walsall. I think Neil Etheridge is expecting Lloyd Isgrove to take this on from there. You see Rico de Henry is trying to get him back onto his right foot. Really well hit.
Well, they've got some elite level quality from set pieces, Barnsley, with Adam Hamill, Conor Horahan, and others. And it's Hamill who'll deliver. Making his presence felt. Straightforward though for Etheridge. This might not be though for Barnsley as Morris looks to make hay. It's Bradshaw. Can't give him too many chances. Poorly dealt with by Davis.
But again, it's a good break. It's a good ball forward from Etheridge. Allows them to get up forward in numbers, Walsall. Ends up being straight out. Adam Davis, the strike from Bradshaw. That's a real sign that we've seen him take hold of a shot.
Winall. Here's Hamill. Horahan onto that left foot. An outstanding season. And part of the motivation has been to prove Lee Johnson wrong. I was reading in the programme, the manager with whom Barnsley started the season. He came into the campaign carrying a bit of an injury, which meant it took him time to get through the gears, but he certainly has done for Paul Heckingbottom. Enviable playoff record, mentioned 2006. He also went up with Sheffield Wednesday the year before from this division. See, he's dispensed with the blonde highlights since then.
Several people from that town probably have as well.
Yeah, I'm not going to remind you about your hair at any stage, to be honest.
You've got to really, there's no doubting where Paul Heckingbottom's love is. He's a real, obviously, that we've made a lot about the fact that he's a Barnsley lad, he's a Barnsley fan, but I asked him in the week whether he can detach himself. I'm like, he can, it's a case of putting the manager's head on as and when it's needed. It's the walk down to the shops that takes a bit longer nowadays when everyone wants to stop and talk to him, but very much got his team pushing in the right direction.
Isgrove, promise again here. To settle for the corner. Encouragement growing. Sean Horan's turn. Mark Roberts striding forward. It's a classic crowd scene in that 6-yard box. Again, Chambers on the end of it this time. Why not have another go? Standing it up, Etheridge. The ball bounced his way. Morris has slipped, unfortunately. Powell popping up over there. Isgrove.
That might be a key area for Barnsley to try and exploit the ball into the box because they have got the ability of Conor Horahan, the class. forgets that he puts in those balls with his left foot. And the signs that are quite dealing with clearing the line at the moment, Walsall. And the bridge coming up there, putting it a couple, managing to mop it up in the end.
Preparing to wind one up potentially. Weapons. That's Mawson who got the flick. Goal kick for the decision.
Pretty straightforward, but it looks like it could be effective. Seven goals this season after Mawson. He can attack a ball into the box with his height and his power.
Seven from centre back. Just useful in the air, he can pack a punch with the occasional free kick, can't he? And he's been a very important figure for Barnsley. There's Mawson again. Away from Sawyers, up to Winall. Made of all that. Here's Lloyd Isgrove trying to get away. Pointed straight for the goal kick. I had a feeling he would not be convinced by that.
He's done this so many times in the game so far, Lloyd Isgrove. Not scared of getting at Rico Henry. Really drives into the box. You know what he's doing. He's looking to come across the fullback. He knows exactly where he wants to go. There's a bit of a pull, there's a shove. Is exactly right, Lloyd Isgrove drives across Rico Henry, looking for the contact. There's as much Lloyd Isgrove going across as there is of Rico Henry looking clumsy in the challenge.
Progress here with Laukovic. Henry. It's stolen by Conor Horahan. Oh, and Edwards losing his footing in the middle there. But it's a poignant moment here at Oakwell. A minute's applause here for Barnsley fan Jake Story, who was tragically killed recently in a road accident, aged just 21. The tribute inspired by a Yorkshire-based Walsall fan, Vinnie Tomes, who was a work colleague of Jake's. Well, that's attempting ball, and in by Isgrove for the flag up. Is this a moment of controversy?
Such a potent attacking threat. He's very, very onside, Lloyd Isgrove here. It's a wonderful diagonal ball onto a straight run. Tapping his run to absolute perfection, Lloyd Isgrove behind Rico Henry, switched off again.
Well, it's becoming a bit of a theme in the playoffs, isn't it? Offside controversies.
James O'Connor, he's the one that's dropped, he's the one that's gone with Ashton Fletcher. Lloyd Isgrove quite clearly onside.
Mark Duncan, the assistant on the far side, making that call, and it's an incorrect one. Emphatically. Barnsley with reason to be aggrieved. Lloyd Isgrove, the unlucky man.
He's given enough warning signs. He's been very, very effective down that right-hand side so far. Really good to see the winger just taking the game by the scruff of the neck and thinking, I'm just going to go at the fullback, I'm going to run him back, and as a fullback you're going to get taken further and further back. Rico Henry's got to do more pushing forward in tandem with Laukovic, maybe even double up with Lloyd Isgrove, try and snuff him out.
Playoff campaign with Peterborough ended in heartache at Leighton Orient a couple of years ago at the semi-final stage. It's Orient and beaten agonisingly on penalties by Rotherham in the final. Anthony Ford. Bradshaw, it's Roberts. One to trouble the Barnsley coaching staff there. Found the top corner of the bench, that one. Dimitriou. Here is Rico Henry. He's 18 and quite a prospect. Downing. Possibility maybe for Morris here, and now for Sawyers. Look for Ford. Only a company up here for Walsall, but away by Alfie Mawson, at least temporarily. Chambers. Dimitriou. That was stolen back by Winnor, and here's Hamill. Situation and any possibility of him getting into a central position on his right foot. Chambers. This is Rico Henry. Morris. Chambers. Chambers again. Ford. Threatened to open up beyond Bradshaw and Milan Lukovic.
Shame because they did have Dimitriou down the right hand side who'd overlapped. It's in a slightly better angle to cross the ball in.
Sawyers. Morris again, and he's got a free kick.
So his feet out this time, Kieran Morris, to drive into the 18-yard box. Cheap one by his grub, just tracking back.
Anthony Ford placing this. Degree of deliberation. Ford conjure here. Well, he can force an excellent and important save out of Davis. Ford. Fletcher is not going to give up on this. Oh, putting in plenty of work.
Just a conventional save here by Adam Davis. Does get across, but it's such a strong wrist that he throws on the free kick from Ford. Look at the distance that he gets it. He gets it away from the danger area. Fantastic keeper.
Schooled at Everton and Sheffield Wednesday, Adam Davis. Anthony Ford. Product of Wolverhampton Wanderers Academy. Bradshaw. Very cool indeed. Scowen. making progress. Well, Winall, can he get on the end of it? Timely challenge by O'Connor, but the danger's not been averted. Scoring shot tame, deflected too.
Just right edge to calm the situation. Fantastic recovery tackle by James O'Connor. Again, another sign there that down that right-hand side, they're encouraging Josh Scone to get forward, Isgrove to get forward. They're really asking questions of the Walsall defence.
Come on, ref! Well, they should be behind. Lloyd Isgrove's goal wrongly cancelled out by the offside decision. Fletcher. Trying to dance his way through, Dimitriou dealt with it. Scoen. Markovic trying to rob him. Chambers. Lalkovic. Hassled there by Isgrove, who's been one of the more prominent. And he's conceded a foul there on the young left back.
Peter Max, if he just calms the situation down, there's nothing sinister in what Lloyd Isgrove's doing. He's trying to make himself as effective and as much of a nuisance as possible. Tracking back, trying to get back. As we said, Rico Henry's got to try and take him back the other way. He's at his, all his own way at the moment, Lloyd Isgrove, getting down the right-hand side. And kind of other side of the pen anyway, he's got to get back and get the tackles in, just mistimes it.
Certainly winning that particular duel, isn't he, by a fair old distance. Is Conor Horo. Irishman. Maybe a half-decent midfielder to be signed by Roy Keane twice. Conor Horo at Sunderland and Ipswich. That's Mawson. He was fouled by Bradshaw. Taking it all in his stride. He is not happy with that decision.
Just trying to get the message on here to Tom Bradshaw, just to keep an eye on the ball, go for the ball. He's got the run on him there, he can run up and take a couple of steps to try and win the header.
And Horahan on his weaker side. And here's Sawyers now. Promise here for the Saddlers. Bradshaw in there. Dimitriou! And action tells you that he felt he should have done better.
It may not look like they've got many players in the box, though, for Walsall, but just on the top of your pitch, Lalkovic looking to make up the numbers. Dimitriou's done well to underlap Romain Sawyers. He gets a sizeable connection on it. He's got the option of standing up to the back post, ends up being straight at Adam Davies and relatively straightforward.
Flick. It's a good partnership, that, isn't it? Winall and Fletcher. A very odd season in some ways for Barnsley, that period when they were in the relegation zone. Bottom in November, bottom three on Boxing Day. Roberts guilty of the foul.
Quick free kick, which allows you to get slightly wider to get a ball into the box. It's taking it straight on. Jason Demetriou's with some power from there.
It's going to be Demetriou. Just a watching brief today, but he'll get into the thick of the playoff action tomorrow. Neil Harris, the Millwall boss here, ahead of their battle with Bradford, and that may be an apt description. Tomorrow from midday, live on Sky Sports 1.
Listen to your voicemail, I think, though.
Robert's ready to hurl it in there again. It is a part of their armoury when it comes to set pieces. Towards Mawson's head.
Such an effective weapon that they've got, one centre-half to the other, with the arrow-like precision that Matt Roberts has got with that long, pacey throw.
Demetriou. Morahan again. Winall. Demetriou making moves forward. Decision going Barnsley's way. To Fletcher. O'Connor away. Here's Bradshaw. Roberts was in hot pursuit. This is O'Connor. A very good Villa side that won the Youth Cup back in 2002, although the outstanding player in that final was with the opposition, a certain Wayne Rooney. Rico Henry.
Really, really good play by Josh Goen there, just forcing Rico Henry back. Lloyd Isgrove, his wingman, had gone on the other lap, gone with Lalkovic, helped him to double up.
Here's Demetriou. He'll make a few more sizable inroads on the other side. Here's Bradshaw's touch, it's away by Skoen. Demetriou, Bradshaw, and Lalkovic is arriving. Great pressure on Josh Skoen as he headed it clear, it's Sawyers. Lalkovic wants it over there. Here's O'Connor. Keith, a notable footballing figure in the West Midlands with the Wolves and West Bromwich Albion. Here's Fletcher. Trying to shrug off Henry, who's stuck to the task, and the final verdict is goal kick. Not exactly a consensus of opinion in the stands, however.
Barnsley, that says, endeared himself to the home faithful. But again, it's another sign of Barnsley attacking down this right-hand side. This time it's Fletcher that gives Rico Henry a little go at. Does it pretty much at the same time.
A great experience this spell on loan for Ashley Fletcher from Manchester United. He said after his first appearance in League One, he learnt more in 5 minutes there than he had in all his time in youth football.
That's exactly what they need. The younger players get themselves out into the league when you're actually. It's not just about performance, but you're playing for tangible points, for positions in the league, and there's a lot more into it other than the actual performance on the pitch.
going out for a corner by Chambers. Coming back to that point, the centre backs are a bit hairier and nastier in real football, as it were.
But I mean, just that, but it's the atmosphere of playing in front of fans that love and really have the club at the heart of themselves and want the best for them.
Morrohan set piece and Etheridge holding on. Plenty going on around him.
Much, much more decisive of Neil Etheridge there. But again, I think it's something that Barnsley may have identified within the game to get the ball in on top of the Walsall goalkeeper.
Knocking up there again for Barnsley. Here's Winall. Downing's footed. Morris. He's found Lalkovic. Now maybe test Scone's defensive credentials. A real burst of pace and Bradshaw's there! And that is the kind of chance he would normally take with his eyes shut.
It's a wonderful chance. That's with a wonderful crossfield pass back here, and Morris, and of all the people it falls to in the Walsall box, John Whitney would have wanted Tom Bradshaw at the end of this. Just really miscues it, doesn't generate the power or the direction on it that he really needs. It's the first time we've seen Lalkovic really go at Josh Scone down the left-hand side.
Certainly filed under the category, if only. He normally would put it away. Hint of handball maybe there from Fletcher. No, Beal. Isgrove. Scone. Downing's header, Dimitriou. Found Winall. Dimitriou not initially able to get a decisive foot in, but it stemmed the tide momentarily.
We just saw again real wonderful composed play from Alfie Mawson coming out the back four, and the instead of the right boot pass into his centre forward, seemed to be applauded.
Standing figure, hasn't he? I mentioned his goal tally as well. Towards Bradshaw. On a horror. Well, some injury news to bring you potentially here, that Mark Duncan, the assistant on that far side, we're hearing has got a slight calf problem and may need to be replaced. Now, I have a feeling, given that earlier decision, that there may not be a lot of sympathy for him in this particular parish at this particular moment. But that's all in a linesman's lot. Here's Downing, Dimitriou. Bradshaw chasing. It's not been his day so far in front of goal.
He always will chase Tom Bradshaw, but I still think they're better served also building through the thirds. This formation that they do have allows Romain Sawyers and Kieran Morris to get on the half turn and try and break the lines in between the Barnsley back four and midfield four, but just going long, a bit too long, a bit too quickly. Feeding off scraps, really.
Does that come from tension of occasion, maybe a little bit?
I think sometimes, but when you have got a willing runner, when you are looking up and seeing him make the runs, I'm not saying Tom Bradshaw's got to stop making the runs so it stops encouraging the pass, but it, as a midfield player, you see the movement and you go for it. Maybe it's more of a definite movement from the likes of Romain Sawyers and Kieran Morris, who we have seen in fits and starts on the ball, but nowhere near enough. Yes. Come on. Yes.
side. Winnall has lashed it beautifully into the net nonetheless.
Hasn't it been an impressive finish from Sam Winnall? Does go very early. You can see it all along the line really. Needs to chip the run. A little smile. It's going up in 5 minutes now. That's why I'm smiling.
Towards Bradshaw, that's Roberts. Here's Winnall, ploughing his own furrow here with not much in the way of support. Although Hamill's arrived, and it's in! And Barnsley have the breakthrough! No surprise about the route to it. Winnall ploughing the furrow, and Hamill popping up with the finish.
Well, these playoffs are about desire, they're about commitment. A willingness to get into the box first and foremost. Someone does so well. It's Brett Linkham again between him and Fletcher. The three Walsall players around there, they've got to take care of the situation better. Just absolutely no awareness of the fact that Adam Hamill has tracked this back post. Great play from the winger to want to get in the box, to want to get his name on the score sheet. It's a fortunate nick, I'd have to say, of Jason Demetriou. But he makes it, he gets into the box, it's going wide.
It's an own goal.
But the reason that comes about is because Adam Hamill wants to get in the box to score the goal, draws out the mistake. Great player around for Barnsley.
Well, Jason Demetriou, his reaction told the story. He got the telling touch, the goal only resulting because of his contribution, if you want to call it that. But they're going in much happier spirits, Barnsley. Jason Demetriou, the unfortunate man in the end, who will be credited, if that's the right word, with the goal that has given them the breakthrough. Adam Hamill popping up untracked to fire in the shot after Winnall had ploughed that furrow. Lloyd's Grove was desperately disappointed at seeing a goal wrongly ruled out for offside earlier in the first half, and Tom Bradshaw had one excellent chance which he did not take for Walsall at the other end. Paul Heckingbottom perhaps emphasising the point that it should be even better for Barnsley at the break, but they are in front. It's Barnsley 1, Walsall 0.
Yes, indeed, sixth versus third in the table, but yet again the playoffs proving to go against the grain. I'm sure the former Barnsley manager Dave Bassett will be happy with the scoreline. Ian Holloway also alongside me. Barnsley, should I say, are 1-0 up. It is a great run from Sam Winnall, perhaps an own goal, but they feel they deserve that.
Oh, he's really put the boot in there.
These players want the competitive element, competing with Europe's finest next season.
Who will be lining up against Europe's elite? Find out on Ford Super Sunday.
Oh my word! I think we're in slow motion.
Carlsberg did kickabouts, they would probably be the best in the world.
Half time between Barnsley and Walsall in this League One playoff semi-final first leg. The home side have had more attempts, more on target, not as much possession, but that most important one at the top is Barnsley 1 or Walsall 0. Dave Bassett and Ian Holloway alongside me. In terms of the goal itself, just how much credit goes to Sam Winnall, Ian?
I think it's a good ball forward, a little flick on, and then Sam is absolutely outstanding what he does. You know, we all got him down as a goal scorer, but, you know, if we watch the action here, he drives with it, he knows he's being chased, and he drags two. And this pass, to pick Hamill out there, I don't know how he's looked. You know, he's done ever so well. Most of the time, people hit the near post, man. He's pulled it back. And at first, we didn't see this, but it's a dreadful scuff by Hamill and hits the defender, Dimitri, and goes in off him, look.
And own goal, Dave.
Yeah, it is. I didn't think it was. I thought Hamill had got done very well to get in on the back post where, you know, if he's going to be cut back, it's that way. I mean, the Walsall defender doesn't cover himself in glory because at that stage he should have been suggesting to win or you shoot, you're not going to pull it back. But well played to him. It was a good ball and just pushes Barnsley just in front, and particularly after the goal that was disallowed.
Should we be saying now it's half-time, 2-0, Barnsley?
I think so, yeah. I've got to say, I can't understand how the linesman doesn't see this, you know. He looks like he looks up right at the last minute and sees him, and then he's going to put the flag up. But from this angle, he is, what, 3 yards onside?
I think what happened, Ian, is which you said, there's one Barnsley player in an offside position. I think the linesman, when he looks, he thinks that he's mistaken that player who's offside for Isgrove.
Yeah,
or the
centre-half steps out and he doesn't see it. But, you know, clearly, I think he's saying, have I got it right?
He's just saying, have I got it right? And we are hearing that he's gone off injured.
Has he?
And the fourth official is now going to officiate on the line. But that's a big call. And it could be a big moment in terms of the tie itself, couldn't it?
Well, we're laughing. It's not funny, is it? I mean, you've created a fantastic ball to the far post. Winger's coming off the line, which you used to try and get me to do, and stuck it in, and they should be 2-0 up now.
Actually, to be fair, though, Walsall have had their chances, haven't they?
Oh, they've been well in the game. I mean, they've looked dangerous at 1-2. I mean, this is a terrific free kick, and the goalkeeper makes a remarkable save. I mean, I thought it was in. Soon it was there, I thought it's in. You know, so that's really kept Barnsley in the game at that stage.
Dimitri loves to bomb down the right. Should he have done better, or did the ball come to him quickly?
He scuffed it a bit, to be honest. I mean, Sawyer pulls it back to him, and, you know, that's your fullback. He's in the box, you know. You brilliant. And that one, he's just got in front of the near post. It's a bit of a difficult angle. Maybe he could have took a touch, but on another day it might go in. But listen, they're really good value. It's a really good game, very, very close. And, you know, goals are absolutely vital at this time. And really, one's been chalked off there, which, well, let's hope it don't cost them.
1-0 it stands at Oakwell to Barnsley. Second half to come. But here at the Cherry Red Record Stadium, it's Wimbledon against Accrington Stanley in the League Two playoffs a little later. John Coleman and his Accrington players are here and ready to do battle.
And it's all square at the break.
Flow. The unmistakable feeling of unstoppable. Of no problem that can't be solved. Because you've found your rhythm. You're on top form. Nice.
Since 1710. Superior then, superior now.
The race of fourth has gone down to the final day of the Premier League season. Manchester United need to beat Bournemouth. Coverage starts at 2:30, Sky Sports 1 tomorrow. Then they hope that City lose at Swansea. That's 2:55, Sky Sports 2. And West Ham's game at Stoke is also 2:55 over on Sky Sports 3. But half-time between Barnsley and Walsall in this League One playoff semi-final first leg. Barnsley one up. Adam Hamill's shot going wide. Jason Dimitriou unlucky with the own goal. It will go down to him. Let's get back to David Prutton and Daniel Mann. But first, David Craig with news of what's happening with the referee's assistants.
Yes, yeah, Scott, there's a bit of a delay here at Barnsley. Mark Duncan, who was the assistant referee on the far side, has picked up a calf injury. He's now going to be replaced by Jez Simpson, who was the fourth official here. And the new fourth official has had to be fetched out of the crowd, Darren England. So the delay is due to the fact that they can't find Darren England a pair of boots that fit at the minute, Scott.
Thanks so much, David.
Well, thank you very much for that insight. Well, drama in the playoffs comes in all shapes and sizes, doesn't it? But the quest for a pair of boots for the fourth official, David Pratton, your thoughts?
Well, it's not going to cost the tanner yet, has it? I think that would be an essential part of any kit-based bag that would come to a football match, but hey-ho.
Well, the Barnsley players re-emerging. Well, it could be even better for them. Controversy involving the departed assistant, Mark Duncan. Well, Jez Simpson, the fourth official, with perhaps more responsibility than he expected here this evening. Well, he may pick up a blister or two he hadn't bargained for with the hastily found pair of boots, but well done to Darren England for stepping into the breach. Well, wherever you look in the playoffs, there's a story. But poor Jason Demetriou, a moment of misfortune which could cost his team dear.
It's tough, but he's done as much as he possibly can to get back and block the shot, but you've got to congratulate Adam Hamill for making up the numbers in the box, drawing out the mistake.
So Barnsley to get the second period underway with that 1-0 lead. Never won a playoff home leg. It is an extraordinary quirk, really. They lost 1-0 at Huddersfield in 2006, won 3-1 across Yorkshire, won 4-0 away to Birmingham City in 2000, and then lost here by 2-1, but of course it was irrelevant. The final where Ipswich Town ended triumphant at the old Wembley. Win all. Great skill from Fletcher in the build-up. Hamill unable to take it off.
It's a real pleasure to watch the link-up play between Ashton Fletcher and Sam Winnall. Real acknowledgement of where each other are.
Bradshaw hoping to get away. Look round towards the referee. Don't know if in the end it was more in hope than expectation as he tussled there with Mawson. Isgrove hoping to get him behind, but Etheridge alert. Big season for Neil Etheridge. It's his first real season as a first choice goalkeeper. At club level at least, reigns with the Philippine national side.
Steadily going into the game, first couple of corners right underneath his crossbar which he had to deal with, but since then, decisive goalkeeping which can only settle the nerves of the back four playing in front of him.
Connor a little unhappy, but the decision is made.
William runners up front for Barnsley, Mr. Fletcher again chasing down a lost cause. He's going to do as much as he can do to see it out, see the danger away.
Orohan ready to deliver. Roberts getting himself free on the near post. Tussle going on there between Sawyers and Brownhill on the edge of the box. Downing
now Morris on the charge.
Guilty of a foul. Walsall making progress here. Anthony Ford coming over to take this one. Is an area of the game that they've put more stress upon of late, because John Whitney was part of a Lincoln side under John Beck that earned promotion, and they, of course, put set pieces right to the fore. It is Ford who delivers. Davis taking action, as he has done when he's needed to. Fletcher got there first, and here's Isgrove now for Barnsley, and he's got plenty of help. But will he need it? Well, Etheridge is there to deny him, and now the glares from his colleagues. But here's Ford, it's really flying along now. Lalkovic. Twisting, turning brilliantly. It's Davis who makes the save, and Ford's effort blocked. It was Ashley Fletcher, the front man, who was back there for Barnsley. Lalkovic again. Now it's Ford. Fletcher only half away, and Henry can pick up the pieces. Morris. Henry. Great backing from the 2,000 or so have travelled up from the Midlands. Henry again. Going in the way. Try to extend the award of a Barnsley free kick, but could have been better for Lloyd Isgrove here.
Absolutely, it's a fantastic break. Dimitri that commits to the challenge against Fletcher, he's got to win it. But what, I tell you what, once Lloyd Isgrove commits Rico Henry, he's got to score, he's got to hit the target, he's got to get the goal, because he has got Josh Brownhill and Adam Hamill waiting in front of an open goal.
Should, and maybe it's labouring a point now, have had a goal to his name that was wrongly disallowed. And he certainly should have made more of that opportunity.
It's just the minute that he commits Rico Henry and gets into the box, the selfish side of him's got to score, otherwise the inquest begins.
Williams. Mawson. Winall. Isgrove. Enticing, and an important piece of defending by Downing. Winall. His name is pretty apt when it comes to the duels with defenders. Bradshaw, Morris, Lalkovic wants it. Scoen with a thou shalt not pass mentality. I'm sure keen to make an impact against his former club, Milan. Lalkovic was frustrated by a spell on the bench recently and returned to the side saying, I'm out of the cage. And here he is, Lalkovic. The deflection which really took the sting out of it.
Commits to this challenge, Jason Dimitri, who's really got to clean Ashley Fletcher out, but brave play by the centre forward to commit to the tackle to win it. Allows Lloyd Isgrove to break. Once it goes past Henry, he's got to finish because Hamilton waiting there to knock the ball into an empty net. That is as late as it comes. Very, very fortunate to get away with that one, Jason Demetriou.
Towards Bradshaw. Fletcher underneath this. But so too is Chambers. And fair and square, in the official's opinion, won the battle. Fletcher. Win all. He's going to take aim. No deflection! Well, he tried his luck, and his luck was in. And Barnsley have this tie in a vice-like grip now.
Such a big helping hand today with the goals that they've managed to score, Barnsley. But if you sit off Tom Bradshaw, if you allow him to set the shot up, James O'Connor not quite as close as he needs to be, which gives the deflection, takes it away from Neil, which gives the goalkeeper absolutely no chance. You know where he wants to put it? It's a dangling there by James O'Connor, takes it up and over his goalkeeper.
Well, fortune smiling on Barnsley in the two instances that have brought them goals. And Oakwell jumping. Here's Fletcher. Walsall have got to get their heads straight quickly. Fletcher. O'Connor's challenge was clean, it's Isgrove.
Look at both goals, put into context, from a point of view, you could say the fortunate, on the other flip side of it, with Barnsley, they've committed to actually taking on the challenge and the chance and forcing the mistake. First and foremost, the own goal for Demetriou in the first half, which was going wide from a Hamill strike on goal, but he made the box, he got there. Tom Bradshaw, Winnall.
It's
as
a
well.
Dazzling run by Winnall! Can he finish it off? Of course he can! Delirium. The Wembley Arch in sight already.
It's a vice-like grip Barnes they have now in this semi-final. Before that, Sam Winnall willing to take the shot on, create something out of nothing, but he does it exactly the same here. And when he's in his position, a man of his form, his ability this season, how red hot he's been for Barnsley. Do so much more the Walsall defence to commit to making a challenge once he's at the edge of the 6-yard box. Can't think there's any Barnsley fan that thought there'd be any other outcome. Wonderfully taken goal.
Well, coming into the game, he had the best goals record for a Barnsley frontman since the wonderful Ronnie Clabbin 25 years ago. He's now equalled his mark for 24 for the season. Champagne on ice, is it going to be Wembley twice for Barnsley? Remember, they won the Johnston's Paint Trophy a few weeks back against Oxford United in a thrilling encounter. Nobody has done the double of the Football League trophy and playoff promotion since Grimsby Town under Alan Buckley back in 1998. Alan Buckley, of course, with a big Walsall connection.
You did just say, Daniel, as well, that they had to hang on Walsall. They were really getting rocked by the attacking intent of Barnsley. When you get Sam Winnall fronting you up, even if it's a cynical takedown, I mean, it's not the beautiful game, but it stops him in his tracks. It doesn't allow him to get into the edge of the 6-yard box to take the shot on.
It's your middle name, isn't it? Cynical takedown. Oh, he had a good point to as well, I suppose. Well, he certainly has. Yeah, that statistic looms at large. It has been a wonderful campaign, and no wonder the championship wagons are circling. From the West Midlands, may have plotted Walsall's downfall, product of the Wolves Academy. By Morris, and having a little dig at him, but Morris will go on. Now it's Rico Henry, real salvage operation now for the visitors here. This introduction of a man who has so long been so influential. Down England, the standing fourth official telling us that it's Kieran Morris who is going to come off.
There's a nod to try and allow Walsall to get a foot back in the game, more of a physical presence in the middle of the park, because they are really being overrun. There's been a slice of fortune about a couple of the goals, but overall Barnes' intensity and the way that they've attacked this second half has been really, really admirable.
We've got to say luck is rarely unearned in the end. Walsall have to earn a change in fortune themselves here. Bradshaw looking for Sawyers. George Williams tidied up. Experience in the playoffs with Hull as a player. Here's Adam Chambers. Manta. James O'Connor. Looking here for Rico Henry. They only need to claw a portion of it back here in the next half an hour. It's realistically on. They've been playing some sparkling football of late, and if they can get a grip of the game early on, back home, stadium, then things could change very quickly. The chant that's currently ringing around Oakwell could be rammed back down their throats.
We've seen this season, a lot of this season, play with some very fluid attacking football.
Here's Sawyers. He's often been at the hub of it.
Also not anywhere near enough in this game so far. We've given the big build-up pre-match and to get up and support Tom Bradshaw and supplement the attack, and he's come more into the game now, but till now it's quite a quiet game for Romain Sawyers.
Sawyers loose, but Manton does give him a little bit of extra bite in there, able to steal it back. And here's Dimitriou. Manton again in towards Bradshaw. Happen for it.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough header as well between the two man mountains of Mawson and Mark Roberts. They're marshalling pretty well.
Well, no team has ever overturned a 3-goal deficit to succeed in a playoff semi-final. Isgrove. Here's Josh Brownhill, who was with Preston last season when they went up through the League One playoffs. He didn't get a taste of the action. Isgrove. Brownhill up. That's Mantum. Bradshaw tussling. Hey, keep that up. Keep that up. Much of his enviable personal record in the playoffs, Paul Heckingbottom. These occasions seem to like him. Still plenty of work to do yet, mind you. Up goes Winall again. Here's Downing. Henry forward. Roberts. Barnsley's way. Fletcher, Isgrove, loose, and found Sawyers. Manta, forward. Mantum again. Bradshaw, Dimitriou. Mantum, now forward. Bradshaw tussling, but losing. Henry steaming after it. Scowen just putting his foot down on the accelerator to make sure he got there. Isgrove intervening. Here's Henry. Sawyers leaving it for Manta. Supporters so far. It's the kind of day when young hearts are won by their football team and indelible memories are created.
Listen, it wants you to say it's not always like this, but it's what engenders the hope and the love within the game.
Catches up it there. We've got a bit of a surfeit of burgeoning young attacking talent here at Barnsley, some of it lying in wait on the bench today, and we're about to see one of them enter the field. This is the cue for the change, but the hero of the hour is the man to be replaced. That's Ivan Toney, who's on loan from Newcastle. He's going to replace Sam Winall.
Fantastic game, Sam Winall. Real effect on the game, what you want in a footballer on the pitch. Not just to make up the numbers, but to really have an effect on the outcome of this match. Sam Winall has done exactly that today.
Soaking up the adulation. The goals that may well have propelled Barnsley to Wembley again.
I might be glad to see the back of Sam Winall, but in Ivan Toney, they've got a player who can really affect the game. We saw him in the JPT final come on, and with Ashley Fletcher, real good dovetailing of abilities.
It was instrumental in Fletcher's goal, which put Barnsley in front, wasn't it? I've seen action with Newcastle this season, a sprinkling of Premier League football. And here he is, possessor also of a deep, rich baritone voice. Was Fletcher held back? Yes, he was. Party atmosphere has taken hold. If that doesn't motivate the Walsall players, Walsall fans, nothing will.
Warm, but it's not that warm, I don't think.
went Mawson. Fletcher loitering. Etheridge decisive. Some slightly worrying early moments in the game, Neil Etheridge, but he's been left with pretty much no power at all over the goals.
Absolutely, as the game's won on, he's been decisive as and when he can. Quite right to say that, but if you look at the goals, he's been left pretty wide open, especially the win on second one, where it's just a dance through the defence with no real attempt at a tackle.
Fletcher, Brownhill, will he get there? Etheridge has come. It's a bit of a let-off in the end for Walsall. It's Horahan, Williams, Adam Hamill. Williams again. Well, he's danced away from Scowen and kept it alive here. Important intervention there by George Williams. Henry to take the throw. It's Manta. We'll get something out of these 20 minutes and the picture changes. By Henry. A long chase that time for Romain Soares. Also plotting a change. And that's Jordi Hueler. In his second spell with the Saddlers. On loan this time from Huddersfield Town. Schooled at Manchester City. News not welcomed by Tom Bradshaw that he's heading off.
I don't know whether it's frustration at the fact that he's coming off, frustration at the fact that he's been ploughing quite a lonely furrow today. He's only scraps the feet up after that one glorious chance in the first half, which that had gone in, the complexion of the game completely changes.
Johnny Hewler's very quick. His time at Walsall, they've worked hard on improving his game awareness. Hold-up play as well, some furrowed brows, some scratching of heads as to what exactly has happened in this second half, particularly here for Walsall. We've seen a lot of the ball, but haven't really made that possession productive.
One thing they can take great heart from is the fact they have got someone like John Whitney in charge, who's not going to get too carried away, I don't think, with if the result does stay like this, with this game going into the next one, he'll have time to reassess and physically work out his players, who's ready to go again and who might need a rest or who might need a bit of a change. Very pragmatic to know that a lot of time left in this tie.
Lalkovic. Here's Ford. Threatening ball! Oh, it was just too much of a stretch for Milan Lalkovic. This is going to be one of those days for them.
Looking that way, but they get more players in the box. 3-2A, Matt. Sawyer's not really committed to try and make in the back post, and Lalkovic full stretch trying to get just a stud or anything on the end of this.
Isgrove. Going. And again, Brownhill, Isgrove, yeah. chance. And Fletcher trying to find Scoen, but they're enjoying themselves now. We're coming almost immediately after we finished here. A playoff with plenty of subplots and wonderful stories. AFC Wimbledon against Accrington Stanley. The two Phoenix clubs do battle in that first leg of the League Two semi-finals. And we had a real cracker in the other one on the opening night at Fratton Park between Pompey and Plymouth. Sam Mantham on the receiving end there, a man who's had a fair amount of injury trouble in the last year or two. Indeed, he got quite a bit of stick when he had that serious knee injury, that he seemed to time his recovery run perfectly to turn up at Wembley for the Johnson's Paint Trophy final.
You know, it's a great motivator. Yeah, that type of occasion. I think you're absolutely right. Then you look forward at the Sky Bet players that we've seen so far, have been absolutely wonderful. Tentative, not a word to describe them.
Davis with a couple of important moments. So from Anthony Ford, free kick, a notable one. Not so much that he got there, but how he dealt with that ball. Really strong arm. Tony. Manta. Through to Sawyers. He's got Ford, Lalkovic and Hewler up with him here. Lalkovic again. Sawyers, Manta. This is promising! Oh, it could have been, and still may well be, a critical moment in this tie.
They've got to bring them out of the shell, Walsall. Putting men forward, they've got better movement in front of them. Sam Manton making up the numbers. Real desire to get into the box. Nobody tracks him. This grove, we've seen a lot of him going forward today, but this is where he's really got to earn his corn, getting back and helping out his defence. Manton's got to go back across goal there.
Hewlett was certainly making that point. Well, that one nestled in the net, then hope would have been well and truly reignited. But as you say, David, he is a man with a great perspective. Fostered a real nurturing environment, building on the work of those who've been there with him in other guises before. Scoen. He's got away from Henry. Oh, Downing had to intervene with a degree of urgency. It's Scoen, now Isgrove. Horan. Isgrove again for Barnsley. Brownhill's way. Scoen. Tony trying to get free. There was a real wrestling match there with Dimitriou, and it has gone the Walsall man's way.
Intriguing to see how much of each other Ivan Tony and Jason Dimitriou actually have. Dimitriou's very much trying to use his body to ease Ivan Tony out of the way.
Well, AD White is coming on here for Barnsley. Going from Leeds in the summer, he's going to replace Ashley Fletcher. Former Leeds man on for the man borrowed from Manchester United. Season that's been disrupted by injuries. Groin, ankle, stomach. Of complaints. That has seen Scoen move back more into his comfort zone, I would say, in midfield. Not that he's done anything less than an excellent job.
Absolutely
at fullback.
Ably carried out the job at right back very, very well, but he has shown his attacking intent throughout the game. Not scared to get forward, but disciplined enough to hold within the back four and make up the numbers.
Ted, still only 24, AD White. Up towards Tony. Come on, come on, come on. Barnsley side, the far cry from the team that lost 8 successive league games in the autumn. Henry away. Indeed, with the autumn leaves, Barnsley plummeted. They are very much on the rise.
Very much testament to the way first and foremost Lee Johnson turned it around, really wanted to get his team back on a good run. It's just what Paul Hagenbottom's done, carried it on. Didn't they really need to change too much when Lee Johnson had gone, but will have been that galvanising effect to think that they can prove themselves without the manager having moved on to Bristol City. Done so, so well, and it's been game after game that they've not been chasing this season, but they've had to get something out of the next game. They've had to prove themselves, and done just that, Barnsley.
Still battling with Gillingham and remarkably Scunthorpe, because they had a real spurt at the end of the season under Graham Alexander. Advantage played there, and Laukovic maybe can take advantage here for Walsall. Isbell. Chambers. Forward.
Just goes to show how much Walsall have actually been in this game. It's a slightly flattering scoreline, but they have been the more clinical of the two. Barnsley, big slices of luck with the first two goals, but the winner goal that you think might tip it absolutely in their favour. Really well taken goal by a man banging form.
That was his goal. One for Tony DeChase, but a forlorn chase. Brought through the ranks by Northampton Town, and what a season they had. He made his debut for them when he was just 16. Towards Hewler. Up in the air there by Mawson. It's Antum's header. Put in there by Conor Horahan. The recognition of the manager's roots by the supporters. Playing career actually began at Manchester United. Robbed by Mawson, but illegally so. Now, is this a window of opportunity for Walsall?
There's quite a bit of pressure on. Does so well after Mawson to win the initial ball, but too close to Sam Mantum.
Well, they're just holding fire on the substitution they're waiting to make, Walsall, at the moment. And Jordan Cook poised, but Anthony Ford has shown already what he's got up his sleeve as regards set-piece delivery. Connor with a spin round to the back. Hewler in there. Like a defender in the end by the look of it.
Davies relatively in trouble at the end of this free kick. Come off the back of his own defender there.
It's Tony's header. Oh, Isco scampering after that. The flag has gone up against him. each time is probably wholly justified.
It took quite a while here to make the decision. Newman. It's for the very, very marginal offside, because it didn't really look like a foul by Antonio Enrico Henry.
Well, Jordan Cook on. All of his three goals this season have come when he's entered the fray as a substitute. Well, Lloyd Isgrove soaking up the acclaim. Energetic, effervescent performance in the man on loan from Southampton, replaced by the talented teenager on loan from Middlesbrough, Harry Chapman. Came on as substitute in the Johnson's Paint Trophy final. Managed to grab a goal on his full debut against Walsall earlier in the campaign. And it sealed that 3-1 victory down in the Midlands. Giving up on it. Demetriou. And they're certainly putting the shift in. It's been a very bright sunny day, and that appears to rock to some people. Hopefully the game can be restarted. Towards Schuller. Tony. So far, so good, but not a time to switch off, because put through here for Walsall could yet prove to be pivotal.
It's going to be applauded on the flip side of scoring three goals and how you manage the game, how you hold on to that league. It's going into that second game, as I say, Dan. You don't want to give any chink of hope to the opposition. They have quite a mountain to climb in the second half.
Some good determined play by Cook. Well, it's been quite a day for Barnsley. They've had quite a bit of luck along the way, though.
Not just quite a day, but as perfect today as Paul Heckenbottom could have wished for the first leg. Real good play again by Samwell. Huge touch of fortune. Adam Hamill getting a deflection off Jason Demetriou. 2-1-0 again. Having the wherewithal to take the shot on, which leaves Neil Etheridge absolutely no chance after the ricochet. A wonderful centre-forward play from a man who's had a wonderful season so far. Cool, calm, collected when his team needed him.
These players can be emotional occasions. Outpouring there from Sam Winnall. Here's Cook, bright and lively and capable of making an impact, but not with Mark Roberts around on that occasion. Here's Sawyers. Looks for Demetriou. Hanahara. So that's a lot of Chapman. Too much. Henry up towards Jordan Cook.
Day's work, setting up a goal and to himself, has been as effective a forward player as Barnsley could have possibly wished for today, but it's what we've been used to seeing this season. It's a very good tandem with Lloyd Isgrove just sat in front of him now, both having a deserved rest.
Of the season so far from the men from Barnsley. Looks as though we're going to head shortly into 4 minutes of added time. That may be a little extended because there's a problem for Harrison Chapman. Give him his full time.
A little bit naughty. It's a game that's not been played in any form of sickness to vein whatsoever. I think the referee's had a really good time of letting the game go when at certain points he could have pulled out his yellow card.
Well, Peter Banks, it's been eventful on the officialdom front today, hasn't it, with the loss of one of his colleagues to injury. But fortunately, the standing fourth official will the departing assistant's boots fitted him like Cinderella's glass slipper. And was able to get into the fray pretty quickly. Here's Brownhill. Scoen. Pumped away by Sawyers. Mawson, Brownhill, forward by Hamill, Tony, Henry, O'Connor, it's just as important that Walsall stay switched on, of course, as well. I mean, three is in the realms of doable, if not necessarily realistic. Hamill.
The three is quite a mountain to climb, but they've been nothing less than competitive within this game, Walsall, but as we said, as we've maintained, there has been a couple of slices that really got on the head.
That's offside. It's Lady White. Brownhill taking a whack up there with Adam Chambers.
Competitive in the middle of the park, Chambers. Brunel gets it flush. The forearm from Adam Chambers has firmly on the ball.
Occupational hazard. To head into the party spirit tonight, the Barnsley supporters, but to give them a bit more in way of send-off here. So much cause for hope in recent weeks. Don't write them off yet. Tony. Oh, he's had a way through here. And Chapman was lurking, but safe hands from Etheridge. Barnsley on the brink. All but there after a tremendous day. Adam Hamill, with the aid of a deflection off Jason Demetriou, an own goal gave them a half-time lead. But Sam Winnall, the star of the show in the second period, a deflected second and a beautifully taken individual third, has put Barnsley inside of the Wembley Arch. A lot of work, indeed historic work, that Walsall need to do at the Baxter Stadium to turn this around. It's finished at Oakwell. Barnsley 3, Walsall 0.